क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 वेरीफाई वेरीफाई एक्स क्यूब प्लस वाई क्यूब इज इक्वल टू एक्स प्लस वाई एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस एक्स वाई प्लस वाई स्क्वायर मीन इट्स आइडेंटिटी वी हैव टू वेरीफाई इज इट करेक्ट सो फॉर वेरिफिकेशन व्हाट वी विल डू हियर वी विल टेक राइट हैंड साइड राइट नाउ बिकॉज यू नो फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट टू वेरीफाई it is somewhere very difficult because we have to add or subtract so many things but if you know move from right to left then it is much easier ultimately we have to verify so we are taking right hand side and we will try to find the product of right hand side and we will check whether we are getting x cube plus y cube or not right Now, okay, one by one we will start this one. First of all, this x will be multiplied with the whole. So, I am writing so that it can be easy to understand. First of all, this x will multiply this whole bracket. Then plus y, because this plus I will take here. Then this y will multiply with this whole bracket. Right. So, it will be x cube. X square y, x y square. It is y x square, x y square, y. Now you can see this y x square cancel. This one cancel. What is left? X cube plus y cube. I hope it is right. Left hand side. Now we have proved it. In the second part, we have to prove the second identity. X cube minus y cube. So again, the same process. No change. Right, so you can do this one. Now question number 10. 27y cube plus 125z cube. You can see it is related to a cube plus b cube and it is related to a cube minus b cube. Clearly it is, we can see here. But, you know, all terms should be in a perfect cube. They are not in a perfect cube. So we will write in a perfect cube here. So what it will be? 3y whole cube, right? This will be 5z whole cube and if I do this part also so it is 4m cube it is 7n whole cube so now it is clearly visible that a is 3y and b is 5z so what is the identity a cube plus b cube a cube plus b cube it is a plus b and a square plus b square minus a right and what is a cube minus b cube It is a minus b and a square plus b square plus ab. So what is a here? 3y. So we will put here 3y plus 5z. It will be 3y whole square because we have the square of a. It is 5z whole square and minus a into b. So 3y into 5z. Right? Now this is 3y. Plus 5z it is 9y square 25z square and 15yz this is the first factor this is the second factor already they are in factorized right now here this will work as a this will work as a b so it is a minus b so 4m minus 7n it is 4m whole square then 7n whole square then 4m into 7n right so it is 4m minus 7n as it is one factor is has come now second factor it is 16m square 49n square it is 28mn so only multiplication part left so there are two factors again in this second part now Question number 11. So here we have to factorize, right? So we have to see which identity we have to use. You can see this is if I write in a complete cube form. So it is 3 into 3x into y into z. A cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc. What is that identity? A cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc. It is a plus b plus c, then a square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc and minus ca, right? So a is 3x here, so it will be 3x, b is y, c is z. A plus b plus c. Now next, square of a means first one, square of second one, square of third one. Now next, minus ab, so ab means 3x into y, so 3xy minus y into z minus z into 3x. So finally at last we can write, it is 9 x square plus y square plus it is z square minus 3xy minus yz and minus 3xz. So it is the first one factor and it is the second factor, right? Now question number 12. So in this case you can see left hand side is related to identity and we know the result of this identity, but right hand side is not in that form. We have to check whether this right hand side can give us this form. What is that form? X plus y plus z, because this is the identity which we have done in with ABC, right? A plus b plus c, a square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus c. We will check after solving this one, are we getting this particular value? If we are getting, then we can say that yes, they both are equal. So we will take right hand side. So it is half x plus y plus z as it is. So what we will do? We will open this bracket. This is square form, sorry, not cube. So if we open the bracket, a minus b whole square identity, you can see here, a square plus b square minus 2ab plus a square plus b square minus 2ab again, and here also the same identity. Right? Now next. X square and x square is coming 2 times, 2x square, y square, 2y square, z square, 2z square. And other you can write simply here. Okay, now what is common in this whole bracket? If you see with each term, 2 is there. So can we take 2 common? So what is left? Right? So if you see 2 and 2, we can cancel. Now, I hope you can see clearly the identity part which we are trying to find. A plus b plus c, a square plus b square plus c square, and here you will write here, we know that this is identity for this particular left hand side, means left hand side is equal to right hand side and it is verified, right? Now next one is 13th question. Here if x plus y plus z is equal to 0 and you have to prove that x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz. If you see the video related to algebraic identities, I have proved this one there. When I have discussed this identity, I have discussed like if x plus y plus z is equal to 0, then what will happen? The right hand side will be automatically 0 there. So this minus 3xy will shift to the other side. So please go through these first video related to algebraic identities, introduction there. So you can see this particular proof there. Now question number 14.